Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat. The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
All right, that's how it should go. Did you guys, so it's just me tonight. Did you guys hear that other song that I've been working on all day today? This is, I just got this like BBC orchestral pack, and yeah, I really like this song I'm working on right now. Because it makes it so I can add like an orchestral sound to stuff that sounds like really good. Did you guys like it? Sounds high? Cool. Who needs that naked guy? Anyways, that was just a remix of For He's a Jolly Good Fellow. Oh, I mean, not that song, but the one before it. You need the Nate guy, Wheel of Money. All right, well, get the fuck out of here. He's not here. He doesn't have power. He doesn't have... Not only does he not have electricity, he doesn't have power. No, he does have electricity. He doesn't have internet or TV. So he might be watching. He's told me he would check in, but he's got like phone internet. But my mom lives in a weird spot where you get no internet. Yeah, I think today's going to be a weird one, honestly. I'm just going to say it. I'm going to say it right now. Today's going to be a weird one. I mean, he can call in, but how's he going to watch the trailers, you know? Congrats on the child. I mean, it's not here yet. It's still got some ways to go, so. But I've never been this close to having a child that I know of. So it's gonna be a hot one. You know, last week I think we had one of my favorite, my all-time favorite submissions, really just two submissions that were sequels of each other that I hadn't heard of. I talked to a lot of my friends who like are big into bad movies and stuff, and they also hadn't heard of these, so... Oh, shit. Light went out. Hey, Sam, what's your favorite sketch to watch from y'all, from us? I mean, Civil War on Drugs was, like, I think the high point. But I don't know if that's cheating. Hey, yeah, I can see chat and sometimes hear the stream, but I only have two bars, so it's jank. That's what my brother says. Is it okay if Sam scares me? Not in the scary sense, but scary, you know, like scary. Makes sense. Civil War on Drugs is a masterpiece. When you wrote CWOD, I was thinking like Call of Duty, Black Ops, or like. Can't hear you, Sam. I'm too high. How is Unforgiven? Who's Oh, Grimworld watched Unforgiven? Yeah, Unforgiven's amazing. Unforgiven's one of the best movies of the 90s. 90s was a big era for me in movies. It's, you know, I think when you're a teenager, movies are that much more magical. I might put Unforgiven in my top five of the 90s, which is pretty huge. I think I'd also put Silence of the Lambs in there, too. So, yeah, pirate and donate. I mean, like, people keep asking us how they can buy the show on DVD or that they can own it. And it's weird because it's like we own it now, but it's just a weird place of like, you have something. If we were to sell it, we'd have to like sell it. And you'd be surprised at how little you'd get by selling something to Netflix. But how much a donation per season, whatever your heart feels like, you know, like it's the honor system here. If you watched any of the Leprechaun movies, the trailers from any of the Leprechaun movies or the Leprechaun movies? So let me go over the show. I mean, we're 10 minutes in, and I haven't even explained what this is. I mean, some of you, one's in the chat if you're new tonight. I'm just always curious to see if anyone's new, but yeah, this is Trailer Boys. This is a show that celebrates trailer. Marth, you're not new. Get out of here. Guys, you're not new. I know all these names. I've seen all these names before. Is this that Notice Me Senpai? Lobo Soldier. I don't think I've seen you here before. I think that's an honest one we just got. Rustin Bendrix, I think that's an honest one. Total Noob. All right. Great. Awesome. So this show, the way this works is we have fans submit trailers to miseryloves.us. I'm going to put that up. You can submit trailers at any point. Like, that's the way it works is... you know, I'll still be able to see you. I'll still be able to see the trailers if you submit them at any point. Text. And let's... I almost tried to type it out on a musical keyboard. And oh, sick. Whoop. All right, there it is. Submit your trailers to miseryloves.us, and we always have a theme. And tonight the theme is what is the theme? It's team 'em up movies. That's team 'em up movies, like as someone else put the character ensembles, like a bunch of people getting together to do a thing. In a sense, you know, like Ocean's 11. Ronin was a good team-em-up movie. But yeah, But like, ironically, solo tonight. Yeah, correct. But yeah, you submit trailers. I'm going to give it a score tonight. Since it's only me, I'm going to give it a score 1 to 5. And I'm going to give out very few fives. And the audience will give it, you guys will all vote yes or no. And if it gets from 75 to 100%, that's 3 points. 50% to 75% or 74, that's 2 points. 25 to 49, that's 1 point. 24 and below, big goose egg from the audience. But from me, you know, I still can give you guys points and stuff. So let's I gotta make sure this is set up, so give me a second, because I'm sure it's not. Okay, let's see, that's wrong, let's move this, let's do this, we'll do that, and I think this should be pretty good. And then this is just gonna be YouTube. And then this is just gonna be, isn't this fun watching me? Just doing here. So yeah, if you think of a team of movies, and also a little tip, I read the context stuff. So if you put your thing in there and give us like a good context, there's bigger, better chance that we'll read it, especially if it's like something like kind of obscure, or like, hey, you gotta watch this because this happens in it. And also let us know if there's, or don't put anything with any nudity in it. No Red Band trailers. I mean, Red Band, but only for gore and stuff like that. The fun stuff. But, all right, let's watch the and watch the winner from last week. Oh, all right, that's looking okay. It's actually a weird size, I think, this trailer, so there might be some messing around once stuff actually begins. But the last week's trailer was for Primates, and the trailer was from Bigro One. Trailer was Order of Black Eagle. All right, I think it's, wait, no sound, right? Yeah. All right, sorry.
Only now, they're up against the Order of the Black Eagle. To infiltrate, they need the lethal beauty of Tiffany Youngblood. But to destroy it, they need... world's most brilliant scientist is lifted off.
Better.
The world's most precious stone is ripped off. And the world's most devastating Star Wars weapon is about to go. It's time for the return of Duncan Jax. And boom.
Yeah, this movie. Here's now, a new thing that we're doing.
Order of the Black
is I'm going to try and
they need the pick
a topic inspired by some of the finalists.
They need to assemble the dirtiest half dozen human tools of
I feel like that'll help us.
Spike.
Grow.
Hammer. Bolt.
Notice they're all tools.
And
Maxi Rider.
So,
the Order may have its army of murderers and madmen, but we've got the...
This is a sequel, also, which is really funny.
Deadliest, wildest bunch of professionals.
So, someone clued us in on that, and the one before it, which is called...
Ian Hunter, the original Duncan Jacks. An Olympic champion.
Which is also finalist, which is also amazing.
Lead the unmasking the Black Idol. Eagle. It's blackest day.
Goodbye, Mr. Jacks.
Looks like it has like a much higher budget than this.
My adventure is about to blow sky high.
They do. This one just looks like they like wasted all the money on explosions. Not wasted, but spent it. Flo Hyman, which, guys, if you have a hard to read Twitch name, Twitch handle, Flo Hyman is out there. All right, now I'm gonna watch another trailer. Just because I feel like we should. Here is the first one.
No matter how overwhelming the odds, no matter how great the danger,
I feel like this is also better. The song is so great. Yes.
One man will succeed.
What's your name?
Jacks. Duncan Jacks.
A hero and a half.
Where is he?
His will can fight. His best friend is more than half a hero.
Oh, we call this monkey. That monkey hates watching him have sex.
Into the fire. In an adventure of a lifetime. Unmasking the idol. No matter how tight the squeeze.
Puts a little excitement in your life, don't you think?
Duncan, this is serious. What are we going to do? Duncan!
No matter how high the adventure.
That's it.
You should have made an appointment.
No Good matter line. How deadly the traps.
With some budget Donald Sutherland in there.
Where Great. Did you hide the map before your escape?
This is not something I wish to discuss in the presence of a young lady.
The monkey apparently has a tank that he rides around.
Must save the world from the evil Scarlet Leader.
I haven't had this much fun in years.
Challenging the unthinkable. Asking the impossible.
Any questions?
Unmasking the idol.
All right, Jacks. No more, Mr. Nice Guy.
Duncan Jacks and Boone. Unmasking the idol.
Okay. All right, now we're going to watch Dune, I guess. Turn auto play off. All right, well, let's check out some... Guys, I told you this was going to be rough. I did see some good trailers this week, but I forgot to... write down...
What did I see that was good? Oh, there's an... Alright. Jackass Force. No. No. Alright, saw something good, but... Now, I might just start it. There is, like, way less... There's, like, so much less with the whole trailer game in... Yeah, in January. I mean, and it's just like there's a ton of trailers that are like fake trailers out. I swear I had a good one. Whatever. Let's just start it. Let's just start it. Start this freaking show. Let's see. All right. This one, I'm sure a lot of us have seen. But, it's a Team 'Em Up movie. And, it's been a while since I've seen this trailer. So, here we go. Let me actually just resize this, because... The window. This is also another weird window.
You zigging? You zagging?
Oh. Oh. Always remember, your bones will not break in a bobsled.
No, no. They shatter.
So, who wants in?
It's a weird movie to have.
We're looking for a sponsor for the first Jamaican bobsled team.
So this movie in theater.
Their dream was to compete in the Olympics. But they chose a sport they knew nothing about.
Great. Very good.
In a climate they had never been.
Cold weather endurance is vital to building a successful sled team.
This is the true story of four unlikely athletes.
How about I beat your butt right now?
How about I draw a line down the middle of your head so it looks like a butt?
Who weren't prepared for what they were about to face.
It's a beautiful afternoon in Calgary, and there is a lot more coming up.
Is this whole thing a big joke?
I can't get my helmet on. Oh, thanks, coach.
Why don't you put some training wheels on that sled?
Leaves a bobsledding to the real man.
You know, you're gonna have to do this on your own one day.
Oh! You have no business here, Jamaica.
People are always afraid of
what... They have a documentary about the Jamaican bobsled team. God!
But they found in each other...
Do you really expect these Jamaicans to qualify?
The courage to give it their all.
Not only are they gonna qualify, they're gonna turn some heads doing it.
I see pride. I see power!
And they took the whole world along for the ride.
Is to follow your dreams.
Follow your dreams.
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
I am feeling very Olympic today.
A story this for is anyone the who dares to stand out in a crowd.
I didn't come up here to forget who I am and where I come from.
And everyone with the courage...
Cool, ready! Yes!
...to stand up for their dreams.
How will I know if I'm enough? When you cross that finish line.
Where did these guys come from?
It's Clown Baby.
Runnings.
So what are we gonna name this sled?
Tallulah.
Tallulah.
That's my mother's name.
Tallulah. Nice.
I like it.
I dug it. You know, as like a definitely gets. Someone mentioned this in chat. All right. So wait, I'm gonna slash pull. I should do this while the trailer's playing. Yes. All right. Vote now. Don't bust nuts. Oh, cool. So I dug it, you know. I thought I have a soft spot for this movie. I thought that was fun. I thought it was a good team up. It didn't feature. Oh, did I get raided by Frank? Frank, did you just raid me? Or are you just here? It seems like you raided me since there's a lot of hatchet men in the chat. Frank, thank you so much. Sick raid from Frank Howley. Cool Runnings. I'm going to give that 3 points. 40 people. Sick. Hey, what's up, 40 people? This is Trailer Boys. We're watching trailers. We just watched the Cool Runnings trailer, which got a 94% yes. So that gets 6 points. I'm not used to having 5 points to give out. So that might have gotten a little bit of the shaft from me. Because, this is hard. That was from Segumist. Six points for that trailer. Okay. Let's go down. Let's see. I'm gonna watch one I've never seen before. This one looks fun. And that was, yeah, that was from Segumist.
America.
All right, let me adjust this just a little. And yeah, there'll probably be a little, because I'm doing the thing a little differently tonight, so there probably will be a little bit of cropping problems, so I apologize. The theme this week, team 'em up movies, guys.
Constantinople of old, the pearl of the Middle East, the jewel of the Dardanelles, Istanbul, the mosques, the ancient streets, the ramparts, the bazaars, the wrestlers, the dancers, the fabled roofs that look over the magic Bosphorus. These extraordinary roofs where never the infidel has placed foot, where... Melina!
Hello.
Melina Mercury, what are you doing here?
I have an appointment.
Here on these rooftops?
Yes.
With whom, may I ask?
With Peter Ustinov, Maximilian Schell, and Robert Morley.
To do what? There's a world of meaning in that, ha-ha. At least tell me, why Istanbul?
Because in Istanbul there is a Topkapi.
Topkapi? Topkapi? Where the Sultan's harems were?
Better. Topkapi, where the treasure room is. And in the treasure room, there is a glass case. And in the glass case, there is a Sultan. And on the Sultan, there is a dagger. And on the dagger, there are the four most beautiful emeralds on Earth. The Topkapi emeralds. But they won't be there for much longer, I hope.
You're not thinking of that.
I can't think of anything else.
Topkapi is an impregnable fortress. Those emeralds are watched day and night. In Topkapi, there are guards, policemen, the lighthouse, roadblocks, constant control, third degree, and above all, an alarm system so sensitive, it's foolproof. No, it's impossible.
Can be done. That's the way it can be done.
But how?
By ruse. By humor. By violence. By laughter. By intelligence. By skill. By love.
They are all means to the end. And believe me, we use them all.
That will be the robbery of the century. The robbery conceived, planned, organized, prepared, rehearsed, calculated, timed to the split second, and directed by the master of thieves.
Oh. I am a thief. Honest. Be there on time. We'd hate to start without you.
All right, the poll is up. Because I was doing the poll, I couldn't see the chat, which is kind of... So I hope everything... here's the thing. I thought that was rad. I thought that was a really rad trailer. But it was long. Like, I think everyone's right. It's long. But it was so, like... It, like, the way it started as like, hey, look, it's Istanbul, was like very cool. Oh, did the Rams win? Oh, very cool. The poll for the movie poll. Oh wow, you guys are really hating on Topkapi. But like, that was so cool. And actually, a little funny thing about that is I was wondering what that was. A 77% no. So I got no points from you. I thought it was such a fun trailer. I was about to give it 5 points. I'm giving it 4 points because I think that is fun. It was long. But that movie, and a little funny thing about that movie, that is, the scene from the Mission Impossible was like pretty much like the breaking into the CIA with the wires and the hanging. That's pretty much taken from Topkapi, which they do like the same exact wire thing in that, so. The trailer dragged, I will say that, but it was cool. You know, I was like really impressed by it. Had the wrestlers, that was really fun. The dancers, also super fun. And then this whole like, hey, what's this actress doing here? I thought that was really, really crazy. And that was from Lobaka. Let's see. I'm gonna go with another one I've never heard of. Alright, here. This one I have never heard of. Should be good.
In a hidden fortress concealed by impenetrable jungle dwells Dr. Abbott Reeves, a brilliant but devious scientist with the power to create.
Help the mandroid from the cage, Takala.
Any malfunctions?
I had some trouble with this. Feels like a delay in the neurosynapse trigger.
And the will to destroy.
Move its memory, then dismantle it.
It's half human.
He must be eliminated. Colonel Nora Hunter has the brains to mastermind the operation.
You need a full-time mechanic, my friend.
Fontana, the river rat.
What are you doing?
I saw this in a movie once.
It was this movie.
When he finds himself in a tight spot, someone else has to pick up the pieces. Kuji, the ninja. He has the martial skills to destroy his enemies. The Mandroid. More machine than man. His special powers will determine whether or not they survive.
He's so big.
We got robots. We got cavemen. We got kung fu. What is this anyway? Some kind of damn comic book?
It is the most.
I don't know. You made it, dude.
One of them has undertaken. And once they reach their destination, they face the most awesome power on Earth.
You don't understand. Soon I shall rule the world.
It's the biggest hint that's like, oh, sorry, I can't come to your house. I'm the size of a car.
It will take all their combined skills to defeat him.
It's a good thing they're having this mission in a big open space.
Together, they are the Eliminators.
Okay. This is better than the Avengers. I think I agree. Yeah, that was a fun one. I'm gonna give that a bunch of the points. I think it's still really early for me to go all five, but I'm gonna go 4 points. I mean, you got Tasha Yar. You got this fucking gigantic. Go back and look at this. Like the tank man is so big. Half man, half centaur, half robot. Or I think it should be half man, half robot, half centaur. It's too many halves. I really dug that. There's something in the trailer.
He must be eliminated.
Time mechanic, my friend.
Fontana, the river rat.
What are you doing?
I saw this in a movie once.
He's a river rat.
When he finds himself in a tight spot, someone else has to pick up the pieces.
This next reveal with the fighting is really funny.
The ninja.
Like,
he has the martial skills
fighting these cavemen.
His enemies.
And like how he's fighting, and look, they're just chilling. The river rat and the robot.
The Mandroid.
How did he shit on that boat?
His special powers will determine whether or not they survive.
We got robots. We got cavemen. We got kung fu. What is this anyway?
And they also like threw cavemen in there? Like, what's up with that? This is pretty good. All right, so that got an 88% yes, and that's 4 points from me. So that is... Okay, that's... It's 7 points to Funeral Cake. Okay. I think I've heard of this one. I might have watched this one before, but this seems... I've heard of this one, but I don't think I've... I don't know. Maybe we watched this one, but I'm just going to go for it. Oh, whoops.
Ruthless invaders, a defenseless planet. Battle beyond the stars.
Have we watched this one?
escapes on a last-ditch mission that begins at the edge of the universe.
Oh, no.
The story of a boy who finds more than he expected. And all
Wait, who
he
is
can
that?
Handle.
That's
Does your species have kissing?
Oh yes, we have that.
Try one. That's a hot dog. It comes from Earth. Do you like it?
There's no dog in this.
Mm-mm. Soybean meal, niacin, dextrose, and sodium nitrate flavoring. That's what we call meat back home.
Beyond the stars.
Sick deal. They want a dog. That's great.
Starring Richard Thomas. George Pappard.
What's George Pappard from?
Robert Vaughn. John Saxon.
John Saxon. What's John Saxon from? Hannibal from, now John Saxon. Nightmare on Elm Street. Oh, yeah. It's the dad.
A battle beyond time, beyond space.
Nice dead fire!
That ends in a desperate gamble.
They'll be able to board us.
It won't make any difference.
Get that hatch open! No!
Battle beyond the stars.
Sorry, watching this on Roger Corman's official YouTube page. Alright, wait. Let me... something up really quick. I remember that this is funny because... I remember seeing this and this confusing me as a kid because it is like this, like... Star Wars ripoff, but I remember being so confused, like, as a kid, because I was like, wait a second, the spaceship has breasts? Like, is that part of it? Is that part of the story? Wait, I gotta put up the thing. That was a fun one. We might have watched that one before. I don't remember, but regardless, I liked it. I feel comfortable voting on it. It's Roger Corman, so yes, the breasts are a part of it. It's the hottest spaceship I've ever seen. All spaceships have breasts, okay. It's like, yeah, they're all, that's why they're all women. You know, it's like all boats are women kind of thing. Starbarians? Oh. I've seen hotter spaceships, but then Mega Maid did something for me. Okay, Battle Beyond the Stars. I'm gonna give that... I'll give that 3 points. And let's see what you guys did. You guys gave it 64%, that's 2 points. So that's 5 points for Battle Beyond the Stars goes to Sam Rules AN. Okay. All right. heard of this one before, so I'm going to go with that. And then I'll start getting to some of the popular submissions, some of the repeat submissions.
Be it ever so humble, there's no place like home.
You can't live here any longer. The building's coming down.
I can't move away from here.
I'm afraid you don't have a choice. I'll get a court order. I'll have you thrown out.
No, we won't let you do that. You better not try.
Are you threatening me?
AFCO Embassy presents Homebodies. They were six old people with nothing to do but kill time. Then they discovered something that made life worth living. Murder.
Why not say killing people?
The surprise movie of the year. Do you know where your grandmother is tonight?
Yeah, or yeah, it was a real waste of kill time. Like, it really should have been kill people. I thought that was great. I'm gonna, it's so great I forgot to put up the poll, but... That was one hell of a submission. I mean, that whole, like, I... Not, like, taking advantage of the kill people thing. That's the only kind of, like... knock I have against that. I thought that was so fun. I once saw a movie in theaters that was like that quality too, where it's like so kind of like obscure that no one's restored it yet. Maybe it's been restored since then, but have you ever seen Where's Papa? It's a movie around the same time with Ruth Gordon. I wonder if that was an MPAA thing, since it was PG that they couldn't say kill people. But I don't know. I mean, like, PG was definitely like crazy. All right, that's 84% yes. I'm giving it 4 points, so that's 3 points. That's 7 point trailer, and that's going to Grimworld. Or wait, is that home? Yeah, Grimworld. That was a great one, Grimworld. Way to go. I'm gonna keep it going with these. 1s that I haven't heard of for a little bit. Rabbit Hole? Alright, I'll look up the Where's Papa trailer. Similar era. This was, that one was 1960. This one.
I hope Mama never dies, you putz!
Everybody has a mom, and every mom grows old.
My mother is old.
Gordon Hawkeyes was no exception. Now his story can be told.
I mean, old.
His mom was pushing 90. How she carried on.
I fell down, Gordon.
Ooh, I missed that tush anywhere.
And so we find poor Gordon.
Alas,
alack, oh, whoa.
Something has got to be done.
What do you want me to do, Gordon?
I'm going to put her in a...
Trying to control the urge to put her in a...
You don't put your mother in a home.
Where's Papa? The story of Gordon Hochheiser, a young man torn between his love for mother and the urge to kill her.
Sid, you have 10 minutes. If you're not here by then, I'm throwing her out the window.
You can torture her and beat her. Get a dog and let her beat her.
You have the right to remain silent and refuse to answer any questions.
But never put your mother in a home.
No, this one is...
Put my mother in a home, Papa.
How many people do you have here?
73, I don't know, maybe 72. I don't know, I didn't check all the rooms yet. Sometimes they go in the middle of the night and I don't get a chance to find out about it till the morning.
You can dress like a gorilla if you think that it will kill her.
Oh, Gordon, you almost scared me to death.
Almost doesn't count.
But never put your mother in a home.
In a home?
She's no trouble. She'll sleep anywhere.
I told you I ain't got no room.
Got no bread.
She's
out in the car. I drove her all the way out here.
Well, what the hell do you want me to do about it?
Can't you check the rooms now?
Can't you see I'm
well,
serving
in this one, it is a monkey
costume.
I respectfully request that this old woman be sentenced to spend the rest of her natural life locked in a toilet.
You can seal her in her tomb. But never put your mother in a home.
Where's Papa?
Where's Papa?
Never put your mother in a home.
Yes.
How many times
Grimworld, I was watching Heat the other day on my favorite app, Pluto Where's TV, Papa? And I noticed that Court, Bud Court
Ron
was the,
Tish Van Der Geldenmeyer,
the boss
and
at
remember,
the cafe. He's in it for like
Where's
2 seconds.
Where's Papa contains the uncut tush scene, a scene so memorable... It has been made into a commemorative stamp.
Where's Papa?
Never put your mother in a home.
United Artists. Rated R.
Mm. Oh, wait. Whoopsies. The tush scene, huh? I think something about that where, like, the whole thing was that the other brother lived across the park from the mom, and so the other brother kept on running back and forth, and you know, like, this is how problematic it is they I think the other brother either, like, keeps getting mugged or keeps getting hard R-word. He keeps getting raped. Has anyone else seen that movie? Interesting. But yeah. Pluto TV is the free app that lets you watch all your favorite channels with all your favorite shows and exclusive Paramount Plus selects. That's right, Punished Walrus. Yes, we are not brought to you by Pluto TV, but we could be. If you work at Pluto TV, we're open to being sponsored by you, or... we have the whole Whitest Kids catalog. We could give you our Twitch content, our Whitest Kids catalog, and you could have a Whitest Kids channel. We could have all our YouTube videos up there. Yeah, call us. We'd love to make it happen. No, I know I sound desperate because I am desperate. Wow, Pluto sounds like a great company that knows a great business opportunity when they see it. That's right, Punished Anus. That's right. So, guys, write Pluto TV today and say you want a Whitest Kids You Know channel. And say they have hours and hours of content for you.
I would love that. That'd be so crazy. That sincere sponsorship. Okay. That was, I'm not going to vote on that one because that was just a, that was just a rabbit hole right there. But here's one that is not a rabbit hole that also is one I haven't heard of. So, give me a second to set it up. Oh no.
Big John Taylor, mercenary, soldier of fortune. He's more than a man. He's a walking death machine. Candy O'Perrin, sexy undercover cop.
Checks out.
Her deadliest weapon is her body.
Well, I mean, Michael isn't Malley, most fighters' Hollywood's deadliest weapons their body?
What do you want us to do? Fight our champions.
Only this time, the action's for real. And Rick Chan, black belt, primed for action with one blow. The death blow. Only two words describe the power and fury of this unstoppable
blow.
Team.
The blow job.
Force. Join them as their carefree vacation cruise turns into hell. On
good
the
job.
Seas.
Wow.
What was that?
Final port of call.
Way to go. Way to pick that up.
Uncharted and unexplored.
That's some self-censoring right
there.
We
should not be here.
Burial grounds for martial arts masters from the past.
You found a trailer.
Their resting place is defiled.
You want a show.
From the dead to
there's some TOS in it.
Who will we?
You needed to cover up with something. Why not dead. Timmy's Primal Scream?
Join John Dresden, Gillian Kesner, Jeff Binney, Raymond King, and Cameron Mitchell.
Guy looks like he can't hold a gun. He shoots like MacGruber.
As they band together with the incredible power of raw force, untamed and unleashed to kill.
That was good. We're starting to really hit a good stride with some trailers. Alright, that was a little extra. Oh, that reminds me, there's we're going to take a little break from this last week. There's something we did not watch last week that I'll throw up. But I swear I'm not being a point slut, but that gets 4 points. I swear, even though I'm totally being a point slut. Thank you for not point slut shaming here. Raw Force got a 79% yes or 71% yes. So that's 2 points. So that's a 6-point trailer. People were like, okay on it. Not completely into it. But all right, so I'm going to go back to something we missed last week. Let's see. So apparently Big Row 1, who won last week, who had the winning trailer, also submitted a homemade trailer because they wanted to show a trailer for a movie and there wasn't one, so they made one themselves. And so here we go.
This Yeti, I'm set for life.
And this was before Meatloaf died.
So, Dad,
that they made this.
Just get my backpack off first.
Find us at the door. Yeah.
So this wasn't like Meatloaf died, and they were like, oh, let's throw in this Meatloaf movie.
It's all right. Didn't hurt you, did it?
No, it ran out of your backpack.
No. Why does like E.T. work?
They must be
no
large.
Other like every other kind of like
snow?
It's a cute creature looks disgusting. Even when it's like, hey, it's cute. It's like that looks scary.
Say you actually found a Yeti?
That's right.
So they do exist. Thank goodness for that.
Did you find this place, Uxbridge, yet, Mr. Grizzly?
Yeah, I got it.
Thank goodness Yeti exists.
In the middle of nowhere with two houses and a dog.
And a Yeti.
Yeah, my Yeti.
Don't do that.
E.T.
Stop. Behave yourself. Oh. Put the toothpaste down.
I'm gonna have to clean up the whole bathroom.
What's
right?
Right.
Jeez, you're all good. Who's the
lard butt? My name's Arnie Blubber Schwarzenkamp.
Is that child like a lot taller than that full grown man?
Oh, isn't he cute?
That's our Yeti.
Can I come in?
You idiot!
We seem to be getting away, sir.
Gotcha! Where's the Yeti?
Oh, he's alone. Did not come back.
World's greatest under my foot!
Give her a little more time, Wesley.
Oh, okay.
We had that Yeti! You know we had that Yeti! We had that Yeti!
Bigfoot's coming, gonna get you. Bigfoot's coming, so you better watch out. Lock your doors and bolt your windows. Bigfoot's on the prowl.
Alright, so...
Bigfoot's on the prowl.
Big Row One made this themselves, and I've going back and showing it because they put the effort in and made it, but they already won. So Big Row One, thanks for throwing that one in there and letting us know about this weird Meatloaf movie. Yeah, okay. Actually, this one got submitted a lot, so I'm gonna throw it in there. I think we watched the inspiration for this one recently. Or one of the things that was an inspiration for this one recently.
Gary, I hate to break it to you, but the world is on the brink of disaster. World crime is at an all-time high. And the only thing standing between order and chaos is us.
Hey, terrorists! Terrorize this!
And just what does this have to do with me?
Last week in Paris, we caught four terrorists with a weapon of mass destruction. We have to find out who sold it to them. Our only hope is to have somebody act like a terrorist. We need an actor. and they say you're the best.
I've got 5 terrorists going southeast on Bakalaka Daka Street. Soon every country will be in complete chaos.
Problematic.
To save the world from falling apart.
And so you see, the new world is inevitable.
It's what?
Inevitable.
One more time?
Inevitable! Things are inevitably going to change!
One team must pull together.
All right, let's move!
It's too soon to be having feelings for you.
Maybe. Feelings are feelings because we can't control them.
And turn the Earth's darkest moment.
Kapla! 3 more cities have fallen.
I can't live it together! I'm not gonna let it end like this.
Into mankind's finest hour.
This isn't about sex, Gary. It's about trust.
All right, let's make this interesting.
Kia!
I haven't seen. Has any? Does that hold up? Kinda, yeah, bleh. Not really. Okay. It was pretty fun. I'll give it a 2. Definitely seen better trailers than that. It was also kinda long. Cannibal the Musical is underrated. Chat's really going for this one. And it comes in at 71%. Which is that other one we just watched was 71%. But yeah, so that's a 2 from chat, and that's going to be I'll go 3. No, I'm going to go 2. So it's a 4-pointer for Team America. Coming later, right along. Let's see. All right, this looks fun. Get so confused because sometimes you guys' names are kind of close. Oh no! Alright. And that was from. That was the first trailer submitted, by the way, and that was from Shaboy the Tom. Shaboy the Tom! Way to get it in right when we name the topic. All right, let's see.
Kill Squad. 12 hands, 12 feet. 24 reasons to die.
Assemble a squad. He owed me a dollar.
Kill Squad.
deadly gladiators with muscles of steel and fists of iron.
Oh.
Their assignment, death to their enemies. Kill Squad, the most murderous collection of men of action ever put together. Defy them and die. That hurls you into a whirlpool of danger and excitement. Six Supermen out for revenge, and God help anyone who gets in their way. Kill Squad, the heart-stopping adventure that brings to the screen the greatest practitioners of martial arts alive in one orgy of destruction. Each one of them, a one-man army of death, betrayed by the only man alive who could destroy them all. Kill Squad. Mess with them. And you mess with death. Kill Squad.
Cool. All right, I want to point some stuff out. I'm going to put the poll up. Yeah, I'm going to watch that awesome stunt again, which I think is timed wrong. This was a blast, this one. All right, so here's the poll. I'm going to go through this.
12 feet. 24 reasons to die.
12 hands, 12 feet, 24 reasons to die. I think it's like not to split hairs here, but like it's like a method of death. It's a device of death. It's not a reason to die. Like, oh my God, he's got those feet. Ugh, I gotta die. Like, and also, like, yeah, each person is four reasons to die. like, I don't know. Like, yeah.
Assemble a squad.
This is awesome stuff.
He owed me a dollar.
You're lying.
Kill Squad. Deadly gladiators with muscles of steel and fists of iron.
Oh.
Their assignment. Death to their enemies. Kill Squad. The most murderous collection of men of action ever put together.
I like this one. Nightstick. Nunchucks. Two nunchucks.
Defy them. Knife. And die. Kill Squad. Motion picture.
All right, yeah.
I really liked that one. Let's watch this again. I think clearly the stunt is supposed to be that the one car jumps the other car, but it is a little off, and it's also like they 73% just missed it. Just missed the 3 points from chat. That's 2 points from chat. But watch it. I guess that's over. It's just like they clearly were like, all right, we got this one sports car. It's really cool. And then we got our junker that we're going to jump it with. It just doesn't look that. It looks like the one car got there too soon. All right, I'm gonna break it out. I'm gonna give that my full 5 points. That was actually the favorite thing I've seen so far, and I don't want to hold on to it too long. So let's see, where is that Kill Squad? Hendo Calrissian submitted Kill Squad. So that's 7 points to Hendo. And what I was going to say earlier was I always get confused because there's Lobaka and Hendo Calrissian. So they're both like Star Wars-ish names. Let's see. Do, 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 do. All right, I'm gonna. I haven't watched this one. I've heard of it, and I'm surprised to see it on here.
Am Weihnachtstag des Jahres 1560 erreichten wir die letzte Passhöhe des Andengebirges und sahen zum ersten Mal in den gelobten Urwald hinab.
Im Fluss kommt niemand lebend hinunter.
Und ich sag dir, es geht doch. Von jetzt an geht es bergauf.
Jetzt geht es bergab.
So kann es nicht mehr weitergehen, Männer. Das Gelände hier ist so schwierig, dass wir einfach nicht mehr weiterkommen.
Hier sind überall Indianer. Aguirre wagt nicht, sich jemals gegen die spanische Krone zu erheben.
Wir sind hier nicht in Kastilien.
Und ich sage, wir können unsere Aufgabe so nicht erfüllen.
Und ich sage, wir erobern jetzt auf eigene Faust.
Sei ruhig, Aguirre!
Ist noch jemand da?
Er macht so weiter, wie er angefangen hat. Du bist meine letzte Hoffnung.
Du weißt, mein Kind, für das Wohl unseres Herrn war die Kirche immer auf der Seite der Starken.
Werden wir über diesen ganzen Kontinent herrschen. Wir halten durch. Ich bin der Zorn Gottes.
That was Aguirre, Wrath of God. I like that. Like I liked that. That's Fitzcarraldo. Yeah, it's just a different time period. I like that. Like we're kind of like an adventurous reach, not like kind of the usual trailer boy submission. Not what you would think for that, but I was disappointed that it wasn't like that. It's like a new trailer, you know. And I think for that, I'm gonna give it 1 point. And it looks like chat is also gonna give it 1 point, so that's 2 points. Keep on, that's to the glass slide. Keep on submitting. I liked where your head's at. I just was a little disappointed that it's like not. It didn't feel like, it's kind of a bummer of a trailer, and this is Trailer Boys, so not that it was a bummer of trailers, but ooh, okay. Someone is speaking my language. My love language. All right, let's see what we got here.
Life is different now. We can't change that.
I can't do the most important thing of my life, to believe.
Our great leaders created a system, the United Nations.
A world full of peace, love, and ice cream.
I feel like we're the only Christians left in the world.
They came in and arrested my sister, my mom.
Leaders created a system of security, the United Nation, united thoughts, united currency, language, values.
Arrested, tortured, and killed.
Danger.
Is this?
Is often hidden in beauty. These.
I like how the lighting matches my lighting right now.
Dangerous.
Anyone? A sweetness out, he calls you his beloved.
Amazing grace.
Stop that, what are you doing?
Friends. I think we have to stop this.
I can get all the phone numbers of the Christians if I hack the police.
Wow. That's a game changer. We could really achieve something big. we can shift something around. Through Jesus, we will get through this hard time.
They may take our lives, but they will never take our freedom. We are humans, created in the image of God, freed by Jesus Christ, and filled by the Holy Spirit. We don't need to fear anymore. We are children of the Most High, and we are created from the God that created heaven and earth.
This guy's like, Christian, what's his name? The room guy. What's the guy's name? Yeah, this is, Christian Tommy Wiseau. Like, the accent is, like, amazing.
The police.
That's a game changer. We could really...
The Christians, if I hack the police.
That's a game changer. We could really achieve something big.
I like also, like, the premise is, like, apparently in 2025, they are outlawing Christianity. Like they're like, I feel like we're the only Christians left on Earth. It's like, yeah, there's fucking tons of you. You're fucking everywhere. You're all over the place. There's not a shortage of Christians. You don't need to be scared. Like, sorry. There's tons of you. There's churches the fuck everywhere. Yeah. This is a really good one. I'll put this up, but also... I want to take a second to do a little deep dive with the Wesley Bros. Okay, all right, the poll is up. Let's see what we got. All right, oh, this is their only movie, apparently. Oh, they have other trailers for this. We watched the third one. Okay, we'll watch another trailer for 2025.
Life is different now. We can't change that.
It's 2025. The world as we have known in 2020 does not exist anymore. The virus changed the world, and communism is all over the place.
It's all over the place!
Developed. Meetings are illegal. Traveling is illegal. Christianity is illegal.
I can't do the most important thing of my life. To believe.
Guys, our great communism's leader, all over the place. System,
the United Nations.
It's fucking Team. Everywhere.
Go! Do not hold back any effort. Eliminate this problem.
I won't give up the fight.
I think they got all this really nice stock
Neither
footage.
Will I. I want to make a difference. I want to change the world we're living in. And I want to make Jesus be glorified again.
Wait, what?
I want to change the world we're living in. And I want to make Jesus be glorified again.
I thought he said Jesus be horrified again. Okay. I want to make Jesus be horrified again. Wesley Brothers! Oh man! Yeah, he does have some serious serial killer vibes. You are right about that. So you guys gave that 2 points. I'm going to give that the full 4. That was Niamix. I know that's pandering, but that's like one of the better Christian trailers we've seen. Actually, I'm going to rabbit hole again. And we will watch the short trailer.
Life is different now. I can't change it.
I can't do that.
Great delivery.
I can't change it.
Life is different.
I can't do the most important thing of my life.
What is the... It says, like, SWAT police, I guess? Or, like... It's probably not a logo, right? Maybe, but, like...
Life is different now. I can't change it.
Definitely Greek.
I can't do the most important thing of my life. To believe.
Our great leaders created a system. The United Nations. Back any methods to eliminate this problem.
I won't give up the fight.
I think we have to stop this.
Oh, that's the other problem for sure. A way to put the year behind the in front and behind of the bad guys all wear masks. Yes, it's, I mean. This is definitely, I feel like, a kind of anti-vaxxer movie, too. I don't know. I got that vibes that, like, oh, they won't let us travel. We gotta travel. Yeah, this trailer's the new Skate Fall. All right, yeah. So, that got 6 points. That was fun. It's just not... like it's ever gonna be again. Here's a fun one. We probably watched this one on here before. We're gonna watch it again because it's one of my favorites. I mentioned it in the stream last night. This is, if we had a film festival, this is one of two of my picks that I would pick. If we had a film festival and we wanted to watch movies you can watch over and over again, one would be this movie. The second would be a movie called 3 o'clock High. I think we've watched this, but this is right on theme, so.
This LTX-71 concealable mic is part of the same system that NASA used when they faked the Apollo moon landings. Worked for them, shouldn't give us too many problems.
They break and enter.
How are we doing?
Car's in position on the fire escape. Mother's in the cable vault.
Carrying to sever master circuit.
But they're not thieves.
We're getting too old for this.
They know your secrets. But they're not spies.
It's gotta be there somewhere. What's he doing?
Hey, Magna, really?
Mr. Bishop, do you mind if I take a look?
Carl.
Grew up.
I give you something to work, baby.
So people hire you to break into their places to make sure no one can break into their places?
It's a living.
Not a very good one.
This movie is about shoes, you're right.
Now they've got a new client.
National Security Agency.
Timothy Busfield.
Relax, Marty. Something. It's just everybody on your team has had some sort of problem in their past.
Now what are you saying? The NSA killed Kennedy?
No, they shot him, but they didn't kill him. He's still alive.
They may not want the job.
Liz, I need your help.
I will not be dragged back into your world.
But they don't have a choice.
Is it a very young Michael Shannon?
We want to hire you.
You're a good guy, Marty.
Can't tell you what a relief that is.
Dick, River Phoenix.
Your job is to find that little black box. We got it.
Holy cow.
David Strathairn.
What the hell is this?
There's a war out there, old friend.
Many secrets.
Oh my God.
How is this possible?
It's not about who's got the most bullets. It's about who controls the information.
Anybody want to shut down the Federal Reserve?
Don't screw around with that thing.
It's weird
all
Brooklyn
about
accent.
The information.
So it's a code breaker?
No, it's the code breaker.
Battle stations.
Do you have the item?
Can you guarantee my safety?
Where is the item?
Can you guarantee my safety?
Too many cooks.
I think you've got trouble.
Here, maybe this might help. An old buddy of mine who was in Desert Storm sent it to me. Of course, he was on the other side.
Now give me the bomb.
Thank you, Berendino, for subbing.
I'm Carl.
Get the fire escape at the end of the north corridor. Go directly north.
Every fun bit like Zach used to do. Oh, about bringing someone in. Maybe next time. Not this time. I'm just not feeling up for it. McGrim, shut your fucking mouth. It is fucking great. That movie is awesome. It's not like the best movie ever, but it is like scene for scene completely watchable. Like every scene has like, I love movies that move. Movies that like every scene we're going to give you something. Everything's kind of interesting. We thought about like making every inch of this like worth your time. And it does. And it has aged very well too, because it's all about like the NSA and shit like that, and privacy, and which has only become more of a poignant topic as time has gone on. And the cast is great, including the president from Battlestar Galactica in there. What's that actress's name? I'm gonna look it up on this other window. Mary McDonnell, who is awesome in it, and yeah. Also, there is one part in that a friend of mine who also loves the movie is like, there's like a really bad, there's one line that really doesn't hold up in that, which is funny. But Rongina worked fine during Collective Souls. With smaller shows, it'd be fine. A smaller show? You're calling me a smaller show than Collective Souls? You're calling Trailer Boys the biggest show on the network a smaller show? I have you out of context here, but smaller than SSS, but I mean, it's bigger than Collective Souls. Give me that. Corners. Thank you. Okay. Oh, only because Collective Souls doesn't exist? Should I get that game? That one that Zach's getting? The one by George R. R. Martin? Elden Ring. I'm gonna take a break to talk about Elden Ring. Wow, Zach, I mean Rongina. Get it, boy. Yes, I should. Okay. Yeah, I gotta. And that comes out this month? Alright. I'm saying Collins would work when there aren't thousands of viewers. Rongina, shut up. There are thousands of viewers. You're just not looking in the right spot. All right, let me watch more trailers. We have to vote on this one. I'm getting out of it. I'm like, or feeling out of it. Getting out of it. Like, my lighting looks like sneakers right now. I left the... What was I just gonna do? Oh, I was gonna do a quick tally. I was gonna look at something really quick. Let me see. One, two, three, four. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 12, 13. 17. Let's see. One, two, three, four. Seven, eight, nine. Okay, alright. We will keep it going. Sneakers, it is a fun trailer. I'm gonna give... I love the movie, but I feel like... alright, I'm gonna give it... Okay, I got a 75%. That's a 3 point from chat. I'll match chat's 3 points. And so sneakers, I think that was just so on theme too. That was from Resident Stevel. It gets 6 points. Cool. Ooh, all right. I've seen this one before. And I think watching its trailer is gonna be fun-ish.
Put your game face on. Here we go. I'll tell you something, it's the best backhand I've ever seen on Thor's hand.
Four major league psychotics.
I've never agreed with that diagnosis.
We're on a field trip to a ball game.
Hit the road, yeah. Don't come back.
When their doctor disappeared.
We run into one complication. Murder.
What'd you say?
Could you recommend a good clinical psychiatrist in the neighborhood? We seem to have lost ours.
Now.
We ran into a little snag out here. Somebody's trying to kill Dr. Weitzman.
I fear my doctor may have been seized by the Romans.
They're on their own.
Kind of wanted by the police right now.
Bummer. They're off their medication.
It's great to be young and insane.
And they're about to give the world a dose of reality.
We're a special combat unit with the United States Marine Corps. We've been tracking some Libyan terrorists. In fact, I think we've got them trailed to a bagel shop around the corner.
Give me a break.
All right, we're four escaped lunatics.
This, I believe.
Hey,
we're
going to
pull Whiteson out of the hospital before those two cops come back.
We are all naked in the eyes of the Lord! Oh!
Someone please take me back to my room!
The 80s when you could just be like mental,
there's an APB,
you know, mental illness.
Came to town to see a ball game. Now they want to give us the chair.
Hold it.
I love New York. Bring your kids. Have them arrested. Do some time in the Big Apple.
Michael Keaton, Christopher Lloyd, Peter Boyle, Stephen Furst.
This is crazy.
I can relate to that. I got news for you psychos. We're getting better.
Stephen Furst from
The Dream Team.
Arise and walk, my son.
Coming soon to a theater near you.
Okay. Okay, that's some classic Keaton. Okay, Dream Team. I keep on hitting slash and then the name of the movie. Is there a way, I'm sure there isn't, that like we have like a form for our polls where it's like I just hit something with the name of the movie and it pops that movie up as the poll with yes and no as the option. That'd be cool. Never heard of that Christopher Lloyd guy? He was in that show Taxi. I was always confused as a kid. I couldn't really differentiate the show Taxi from the movie Taxi Driver. And I was like, what's the big deal? It's got Locke in it. That's cool. Oh, wow. 69% yes for Dream Team. I liked it. I'm going to give that 3 points myself. So that's a 5-point trailer. 5 points going to Almobes. Alex. Okay. I'm going to watch this trailer for a second before I show it. Make sure it's okay, suitable. It doesn't sound suitable right now.
I knew we hadn't heard the last of this. It's Ted, isn't it?
Gotta be. Last thing he said to us was he'd never forget.
I thought he was in some mischief.
Okay, all right. Let me scan this. All right. I think that was a joke in the description from Jay Nihilist. They say something flops out that's bigger than a baby's arm. And I was like, is there...
It's Ted, isn't it?
Gotta be. Last thing he said to us was he'd never forget.
I thought he was in some institution somewhere.
He's out.
He's out?
I just called there.
He's a raving maniac.
That's right. Either he got better or he put on a damn good act. Important thing is he's out.
Good acting. I like the rhythm of that scene.
And you get an arm in the mail. An arm! And you don't report it?
You're damn right. Can you imagine the headlines?
Alright, that was a new trailer, but it was pretty good. I don't know if I spelled that right. Okay, severed arm. Something bigger than a baby's arm flops out in the first few seconds. So I guess it's an ensemble thing. Didn't really... I'm gonna, you know, probably take points off for... It didn't feel like an ensemble movie. Like, it, as much as it's like, all right, we saw some... It didn't feel like those other ones where it's like, hey, there's this guy, and there's that guy, and there's this guy. But it was really cool. Okay. All right, that got a 69% no, which means that it's a 20 or 31% yes, so that's 1 point. And I'm going to give that 2 points. So that's to the severed arm, Jay Nihilist. You get 3 points. Okay, this looks cool. All right. Oh, weird. I thought this was the same movie. It's just the same company.
That's a promise. Bet you won't put your trust in me. Bet you won't let me go further than you can see. Bet you think I planned something and won't say. If you think I'm thinking of a slicker way. That's a promise.
It's getting a lot of points in the song.
That's a promise. I'm gonna blow your mind. How many times have I shook your hand? How many times have you walked away saying I'm your man? Count the times you've made me cry. If you think I'm gonna keep trying until the day I die. That's a promise.
I'm gonna get ya.
That's a promise.
I'm gonna blow your mind.
That's a promise.
I'm gonna get ya.
That's a promise.
I'm gonna blow your mind.
Death promise.
Who sent you?
I swear to God, I don't know. Somebody gave me $50 to pull the wires out.
This Vinegar Syndrome Blu-ray company seems fucking cool. Death promise. Was that? We're gonna get you. Okay. I thought that was a lot of fun. They have a lot of fun stuff. I'm gonna give that one. It seems kind of like similar to the Alamo Drafthouse stuff, where they find like an old fun thing. I'm gonna give that one me myself. I'm gonna give them 4 points. Yeah, 4 points for that one. And when porn and so that's 3 points from Chad. That's a 7-point trailer for Poop Pants McGee. Poop Pants, was that your first trailer? I'm gonna guess it's your first 7-point trailer. How am I doing, guys? Am I keeping it up? Am I keeping the energy up? Because I am not feeling the energy. Welcome to the board, Poop Pants. You're having fun? All right, cool.
The truth.
Let's get straight to the biscuits. World War II. The Nazis are making their mark on Europe. Adolf Hitler wants to take the world and keep it all for himself. Hitler's days are numbered because Danger 5 are on the case.
Get your fascist mouth away from me!
You hit the wall!
I hit
the Nazi.
Scouring the furthest corners of the globe.
Yeah, to this unravel
Hitler's most sinister plans.
Now it looks like Hitler is using the bullion winnings from his casino to rearm the entire German army with superior golden super weapons made of gold.
Ilse was married to Rommel.
I've been married to things a lot scarier than Nazis, my friend.
Marriage is a waste of time, if you ask me.
As long as this is intact, any organism as a crystal implant is completely under our control.
Und ich lade die Alliierten gerne dazu ein, ihn hier so weit unten zu finden.
Well, I guess you have no more mutants left for them to fight. You may as well pardon them.
Oh, I'll pardon them. I'll pardon them each in the face with my gun.
Wait! Don't!
Гитлер император использует это место для зомбирования людей. Здесь они превращают их в солдат-роботов. Такер.
Дубо, аригато.
Danger 5 is armed with a cast of powerful newcomers. David Ashby as Jackson. Aldo Mignone as Pierre. Sean James Murphy as Tucker. Natasha Ristich as Ilse. Amanda Simons as Claire. And Carmine Rousseau as Adolf Hitler.
Oh, I met these guys before. Watch football. They're friends of friends. They're Australian.
Danger 5.
Okay. This is one of the least sexy movies that contains Nazis and a character named Ilse. It has a website. Yeah, you're right. It's an amazing show. Is it Australian? Can anyone confirm that? Oh, this is the TV show, not a movie. Yes, Australian. So yeah, I met some of the guys that made that once. It's not a movie. Points off. I'll give it 2 points. Oh, wait. And now you guys gotta give it points. I keep on doing slash in the name of the movie rather than slash poll. No movie, no vote. It's on Prime. No movie, no vote. That's what people are saying. All right. I'll go by that rule. I mean, it's my show. It's got to be a TV show. Or got to be a movie. And that apparently is not a movie. I'm just not even gonna find it. I'm not even gonna. That was Licorice Liquor. Okay. Oh, okay. Since Licorice Liquor says it, I'm gonna give you 1 point for being honest. Wait, I'm gonna go through and. All right. Let's see. Give me a second. I'm gonna kind of take a browse, make sure I'm not missing anything. Okay, oh, this looks fun. All right. Ooh. I feel like I'm like a fun mom. This looks kind of jazzy. Okay. Ooh, fun.
Kelly!
hell are you doing here?
Looking after the colonel, that's what.
Shoot him and let's get the hell out of here.
Shoot him, we don't get the gold.
What gold?
Proposition.
Like you might be interested in helping me out.
Oh.
I want you to set up a barrage for me.
Yeah.
If you whisper one word about the gold to these guys, I'm gonna have you bounce from this outfit so fast your feet won't even touch the ground.
Telly Savalas was the original Vin Diesel.
What is it?
I want the intelligence reports of this whole sector, and I need them in the next 2 hours.
That's nice. What's in it for me?
It's behind enemy lines.
I got 3 Shermans outside.
His name's Oddball.
A Sherman can give you a very nice edge.
Donald Sutherland, looking hot.
These are my boys.
It's like this Cali, it's like hippie-ish.
No, it ain't.
Look, baby, I'm kind of hung up. I need about 60 feet of bridge.
Listen, kid, they haven't got your back in a nut ward again, have they?
I don't need you. 60 feet of bridge I can pick up almost anywhere. Schmuck.
All right. I need at least 100 guys. Where do I find 100 men just like that?
Oh, is that the guy from Seinfeld that plays like
my hair is still in curve.
His like uncle, Jerry's uncle.
Find 100 men just like that.
Right?
I need at least 100 guys. Where do I find 100 men just like that?
Uncle Leo.
Show up, Kelly.
Yeah.
Come on, let's move it up.
But my hair is still in curves.
Oh, that's a freaking. What's his name?
Nobody said anything about flapping his 30 caliber machine.
Harry Dean Stanton. Thank
you. I'll make it $50 if you carry the machine gun, huh?
Fire!
I thought you said 3 Shermans.
This cast fucks.
Those nuts have brought half the army with them.
What is this? Hey, what is this? A ball game? Who are these guys?
My friends, okay?
And who's that bunch of refugees over there?
The band.
The band? What do we need a band for?
Come on, little face, Captain. They're beautiful people.
You see, we're just a private enterprise operation.
Those freaks! That ain't an army, it's a circus!
It could be the perfect crime.
Alright. That was Kelly's Heroes. So wait, the Super Bowl next week is going to be Cincinnati against Los Angeles, huh? Who'd have thought that? Wonder what the Vegas odds on Cincinnati winning the Super Bowl were at the beginning of the season. Kelly's Heroes. I'm going to give that 3 weeks. The Bengals, not the Browns. Browns are Cleveland. Oh yeah, so we're going to have a show next week, but not in 2 weeks because of the Super Bowl. Unless we have like a Super Bowl show. I lost my life savings on that game and crypto. All right, so Kelly's Heroes got 78%, so that's 3 points from chat. I will match that and give it 3 points. That was a fun one. And you know what, guys? I'm getting there. So, sorry if it's a slow show. Or not a slow show, a short show. I'll do two more. Once I find this last one. Okay, oh, then that was from Dean Domino. That's 6 points to you. Okay. Let's see. Next one. I saw this when it was out in theaters.
Bye bye.
I don't think I saw it in theaters, but.
Hey, kid. You want to take a little run with me?
Yeah. I'll take a little run with you. Man,
oh man. You're almost as good a getaway driver as me.
I'm about to get my pimp thing on started. Why are you always talking about this pimp stuff, man? What's happening? Women so pretty. Even man, I ain't afraid of no war. I just want to do something that's different.
Yeah, well, getting your head blown off is different.
Man, oh man. So then you ain't gonna marry me when you get back.
You ain't got somebody else.
I don't want nobody else.
To the Bronx. Now you gonna play this Marine War hero.
What you got when you get back here, huh?
What's going on, man?
Girl, come here. That's Daddy. Say hi.
I'm gonna get myself a good job.
Don't you know if I had anything to offer you, I'd have given it to you the moment you walked through that door?
We don't need his money.
And you can't even put food on your table. Me and Kirby got something in the works.
Old bills, man. Sometimes a couple million.
All that money.
At 6:15 a.m., the truck pulls out of the post office. Now it makes one stop before it goes to D.C. at First Federal Loan and Savings.
You pull it off, and you'll have money hands over fist.
I think we need another man on the street.
We might as well put an ad in the paper, then we're gonna get everybody.
I'm qualified to handle a 45, an M16, and AK-47.
I want to watch this movie again. This is like half this movie is a Vietnam movie. Keith David. He's great.
Lorenz Tate. Keith David. Chris Tucker. Nabuche Wright. From the directors of Menace to Society, Dead Presidents. A Hughes Brothers film.
Well, that's Uncle Sam for you, baby. Money to burn.
Yeah. Who's that? Is that Isaac Hayes? Walk on by. Whiteface problematic? No, whiteface is fine. Uh, we have this mummy Halloween decoration that sings. What is this? Dances to the song. Okay. Yeah, yeah, Isaac Hayes for the second. Yeah. That's a good song. I feel like Portishead samples that, and I feel like Wu-Tang also samples that. It's a good song. All right. Poll. I'm just powering through this, guys. I can't believe ICP ripped off this movie. All right, Dead Presidents. I'm going to give that 3 points. Okay, yeah, 3 points. That feels right for me. Okay. Portishead, all mine. Oh, yeah, okay. Cool. I like Portishead. Good band.
The first sound.
Okay, that got a 72% yes. That is 2 points. And 3 points from me, so that is going to, I believe that's Big D Liquor. Let me double check this. Big D Liquor, 5 points. Okay, last trailer of the night. Okay. Here we go.
Mr. Mind and Presence, Mr. Emotion, Mr. Memory, Mr. Heart, Mr. Will, Mr. Conscience. There's some old business I want this board to address.
We are guilty. Are you seeing this?
See what?
The light.
And why is it so important to these Christians that everyone believe like they do?
Tell us what happened that changed us.
You're asking us to give up everything that makes us happy.
That scarred us.
I will not let this board be misled by lies and myths.
Tell us what happened.
It's 12 Angry Men.
God, I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
And Inside Out.
Move over, but I'll do
no.
It.
No, wait.
All right. Tell you.
Who's that?
I am insulted that God would send anyone to hell.
Whose side are you on?
I love Christian's idea of what cool is.
What is your problem?
Something
needs this to cool guy.
One to change.
Like spiky hair. This other cool guy with black and on black.
This is a matter of the heart.
Let him in.
But it's spelled B-O-R-E-D. Works for this trailer, too. Yeah. Thank you, Ranjana. Okay. The board. Box office poison. All right. Okay, the poll is up for the board. Take one last scan. Alright, I'm gonna throw one up that was just submitted while, or actually I'm gonna, that was 73% no, so that's 1 point, and I'll also give it one. I the other one was such a more fun, that was from Alan Smithy, appropriate. So I'm gonna give that another 1 point, so that's a 2-pointer. It really just, I think, suffers from, it's almost too competent while it's so bad. Yeah. All right, so let me look at what we have. As far as, we have a couple sevens here. 3 sevens, 4 sevens. All right, we have 4 sevens and a bunch of sixes. So let's see, for the poll for this week, we have Kill Squad. We'll probably just cap it at 4 since we had 4 sevens. Kill Squad got 7. The Eliminators got 7. Homebodies. Got 7. And Death Promise got 7. What a great lineup of movies. And that, with this, it gives me an idea about what we're going to do next week. I think this fits in with my recent obsession, my recent TV obsession. Trailer of the Week is up right now. I think I only put it up for a minute, so get your votes in right now. All right, so what I'm going to do for next week's theme... Oh, I could do football... because there's a football thing. But I want to do, I think because based on this, I'm going to do old people. Do like movie trailers. It's not that it has old people. It has to be like about old people. Like Cocoon 2. Las Vegas, like those, like old people, grumpy old men. Yeah. Over my Android. Yeah. Yeah. We have to, it has to be a movie. All right. For the win. Homebodies. That looked good. All right. That's funny that that's the one. It's got to be movies that have a mandroid in them. A guy that is part man, part tank. Alright, Homebodies. And that was Grimward with Homebodies. Trailer of the week. Alright. Thanks for... Yeah, technically Highlander is really old. But like, you know, like... What's that movie? Book Club? That movie was dope. But yeah, and just so you know, the TV show I'm talking about is And Just Like That, where they're constantly talking about how fucking old they are. I think that'll be a fun week. So old people. Submit movies about Clint Eastwood and Tommy Lee Jones go to space. I think someone submitted that for this week, and I was like gonna find it, but I didn't like see it in time, and so I'm sorry, but yeah, I think that totally fits. Thanks for coming by, guys. I'm gonna see who's on. Ooh, Dad Feels is on. I'm gonna raid Dad Feels again. Nathan Barnett. Thanks, guys, for coming back. We'll be here next week, but we won't be the week after. Or maybe we'll do something else fun. But maybe we will, but like after the game. Enjoy Dad Feels. Or maybe it's Keith Apicary. Do, do.